Hey, I'm Akhil. I'm a PhD student in the Biologically Inspired Robotics Lab. I'm an international student. I came to the US in 2013 as a master's student. And in 2014, I shifted to move to a PhD program. And I've been doing this ever since. So we work, being in the Biologically Inspired Robotics Lab, we're working with robots which are inspired by nature. And for me, I'm working with earthworm-like robots. So we're trying to figure out how earthworms move, and then we're trying to emulate that in as a dynamical model and build robots based on that. So here I have two segments out of the robot we built over here. And just like an earthworm move locomotes, this does the same thing. As one segment contracts, the other one expands and a series of waves is sent down the body. And that motion is called peristalsis. So it's a soft robot. So one of the cool things about this structure that we designed, this mesh we have over here, is they use these 3D printed parts which we printed at ThinkBox, and we use air hose fittings over here which allow us to like connect two tubes together kind of thing. So we've used the same design, and if you pull on it, nothing happens, but if you press this little button over here, it just comes out. So that's the modularity of our robot. So again, being in the Biologically Inspired Robotics Lab, we build robots which are essentially mechanical and electrical components, and biologically trying to figure stuff from nature. So working with the biology department, they do all the studies on the animals. Like they figure out how they move, what are the forces, and we help them do that. And then they help us build models based on that. And then we design the controllers with the help of ACS department and our department as well. And all the manufacturing, all the 3D printing with the help of ThinkBox and stuff like that is pure mechanical. Right now, being a soft robot, there are a few challenges which we faced, and we want to improve on the design. We want to make it a little smaller, make it more compliant and modular. Apart from that, we're trying to build better controllers. So right now at this size, we're trying to use it to inspect pipes. The way they do it right now is they send compressed air in a pipe, and to do that, they need to stop the flow of liquid or fluid or whatever's flowing through the pipes completely. But with this, you can just like lower the flow kind of thing and send it through. It's an autonomous robot. It's going to go ahead. It's going to move through the pipe on its own. And then it's going to detect if there's something wrong. It can have a camera mount ahead over here, or it can have a 3D printing tool. And if there's some leakage or there's a hole or something, it's going to fix it temporarily until people can get down there and fix it.